This is the keyboard layout of the latest Mac. It comes with touch bar on the top. This touch bar is very powerful. It changes its behavior based on the application that is in use. So if you use Safari, it actually shows options related to Safari. If you use some other application which can understand this touch bar, it actually shows the keys based on that application. Below that we have the number pad and the QWERTY keyboard here. And then the major change between the traditional Windows-based keyboard and Mac-based keyboard is that there is no insert button in Mac. And also there is no backspace. Whereas traditional Windows keyboards have backspace, and also many of the Windows keyboards have insert also. This keyboard doesn't have insert. However, many of the Windows-based keyboards have insert as well. Also, many of the Windows keyboards will have this number pad so that you can type a bit faster, but Mac Book Pro's keyboards will not come with number pads. Then when it comes to the last row, on either side of the space we have command. So command is very extensively used in Mac. And then we have option with alt. We can say function and press this key and it will actually act as alt. And then we have control button. And we have shift button on either side in this row. That being said, if you want to get function keys, you just have to press Fn and the touch bar will change to function keys. Whereas if you look at the Windows-based keyboards, it will typically look like this. Most of the recent Windows laptops also doesn't with the keypad like this, but still some of the Windows-based keyboards, even on laptops, will come with this number pad. And then you will have a Windows key in Windows. That Windows key is not available in Mac. So that's the major difference when it comes to a keyboard. Now when it comes to Windows, if you prefer to use shortcuts, we use Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V for copy-paste. But when it comes to Mac, that Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V will not work. You have to use Command-C and Command-V. And also, as Mac doesn't have backspace to delete backward, we have to use Command and Delete to delete something on Mac backward. Otherwise, if you use Delete, it will typically delete forward only. It will not delete backward. So these are some of the subtle differences which you need to be aware of because of the keyboard layout differences between Windows-based keyboard and Mac-based keyboard. Also, I would highly recommend you to get used to this touch bar. It has so many options and more importantly, it changes based upon the context of the application and it actually gives some of the commonly used features of those applications if they are integrated with the touch bar. So spend some time and get used to the touch bar. It is very, very powerful. That being said, I have already covered some of the key differences between Windows-based keyboard and Mac-based keyboard. If I have to explain anything related to this, I will create separate videos as we proceed further. But for now, these are good enough to get started.